get to some of these questions about refinancing. And luckily, we actually have someone that knows a lot about refinancing.
Right. Dale Vermillion is with us here. He's the author of Navigating the Mortgage Mess, Simple Truth About Financing Your Home. Dale, good to see you, by the way. Thanks so much
great
for
to
coming
be here.
In.
Thank you so much. Hi, Jenna.
Hi.
I saw you on television with Dagan earlier, and I think Dagan's going to come up and join us in a little while, too. And it was a very interesting conversation for those who didn't see it on the Fox Business Network. And we will get to Larry out in California in a little while, but we were just started to have this conversation as you were walking in about refinancing, and so many people are thinking about it now. What should be the first thing they think about in terms of, because now we used to hear those old rules about, you know, how much the rate should fall and everything else. Are all those out the window, or are there some real rules of thumb when you think about refinancing your home?
You know, you hear things like the 2% rule, and those things, those rules really don't apply today. We are at a 38-year low in interest rates right now. It's a great time to refinance. And I would say that for people who are considering refinancing today, the real key is don't look at the traditional things people usually do, which is just lower your rate and lower your payment. With the low rates today, you can also reduce your terms, you can increase your tax deductions, you can get cash sometimes at no cost. There's a lot of things you can do in refinancing.
How do you ask that? I mean, how do you approach someone and say, can you not only lower my rate, or instead of lowering my rate, what about making sure that I pay less years on that? How do you even... I don't even know how I would feel about it. I would feel nervous about asking someone about that.
That's a great question. I talk in my book about the perpetual refinance. We do this all the time. It's the 30-year lower my rate, lower my payments, and we just keep doing it again and again. There are a lot of 25 and 20-year programs out there that many consumers don't even know exist with lenders today. So if I go to a lender, when I go to them, I want to say, look, I want to take advantage of these low rates today. And what I'd really like to do is not just lower my payments, but what about getting into a shorter term? Can you help me reduce the term on my mortgage so that my overall payback is far less? A simple example of a $100,000 loan. If you take a 5.5% rate today, for $45 a month, you can take a 30-year down to a 25-year and save yourself over $20,000 over the term of the loan.
So you say, go ahead.
Well, I was just going to get to some of the questions. You want to follow up on that?
Yeah, no, I mean, just saying the idea, I mean, these and 15-year mortgages have become more and more popular, right, for people that can afford them. But that can be that's a little more costly. But the rates are pretty good on those 15 years versus the 30 years.
The rates are better. Right now we're below 5% on 15-year terms. It's the best rate you're going to get. But many people can't afford. The difference between a 15 and a 30 is pretty large. A 30 and a 25 or 20, not large at all.